What is zindex? It's a CSS property that allows us to manipulate the layering order in a HTML document. So no doubt you're already familiar with layering options in software such as Microsoft Word and also Adobe Photoshop. Zindex is essentially the same thing, except it's for CSS and HTML. Here I've got an example of a number of different pictures that are layered one on top of the other. I've just got some simple JavaScript here to change the zindex property on them. Let's dive deeper into zindex. Diving deeper into the code, I can see I've got HTML here, five different image tags, displaying all the five different images we saw in the browser window. Usually with that, without any styling, I just have each of the different five images displayed one after the other. But there are several examples where I can get those different images to overlap one another, and where zindex might become useful. Different values of the position property like absolute, relative, and sticky, but also the flex layout system, and in some instances, the grid layout system also could use the zindex property. Let's just focus on one of those examples, that's setting the position property of all of these images to absolute and layering them one on top of the other. Adding a style sheet, in this case an internal style sheet into my code, I can set the position property to absolute for all of the images. And then for each of the different items, I'm just going to set them one on top of the other, slightly changing the top and the left properties so that we get the effect that we see here. Because we've set the position to absolute and we have layered them using the top and left values to put them one on top of the other in this cascading type of style, the way that the browser interprets that is it just follows it in the same order in which the HTML image tags were met in the code. Zindex comes into play when we want to alter that order. Let's focus on the third item here. What if I want to bring that image out to the front? I can find that property that's controlling that item and just set zindex, which is z-index. And the value that I'm going to set that to is just some absolute number. It doesn't matter if it's negative or positive. In this case, I want to make it positive. And whatever number I put in there, it's going to lift it out above all the other z indexes, keeping in mind that the default z index of all the different items is 0. So if I set it to 1 and save and go back and refresh, it's going to pull that out to the front because all of the others by default are set to 0. Remember, I can also put in negative figures as well. So let's focus in on item number 2. Let's say if I want to push that back to the back, I can just take a z index there. In this case, I'm going to set it to minus 1, and you can see that I'm pushing that to the back. I don't have to keep my z-index in any particular sequence. So for example, this fourth item here, if I want to pull that to the front, I'll set z-index and I'll put it to 10. Save and go back, and it's going to pull it out to the front. So it doesn't matter that there's a gap between the previous 1 and to 10. The browser doesn't care about any of that. It just interprets it and reorders the different items based on all the z-indexes that it meets. And remember, even though we're dealing with images in this example, it doesn't matter whether it's images, text, or any other different object that's within the HTML page, z-index will control them all. For the final piece, to show you the example that I showed at the beginning of the video where we use JavaScript just to dynamically change the z-index properties of each of these different images, just go back to the code. I'm going to remove all the different Z indexes that I've put in so far. I'll then insert a little onclick event handler to call a JavaScript function called ImageToTop. And I'm going to include that ImageToTop function at the very top in the head section. And we get the overall effect here. And that's a very brief introduction to the Z index property. Thanks for watching.